mountains of my home, of the mountains where in childhood I would roam. I have dwelt neath southern skies, where the summer never dies, but my heart is in the mountains of my home. I can see the little homestead on the hill. I can hear the magic music of the rill. There is nothing to compare with the love that once was there in that lonely little homestead on the hill. Quiet churchyard down below, where the mountain breezes wander to and fro. And when God my soul will keep, it is there I want. That loved me long ago.
It began here at Dinas a century and a half ago. This patch of black shale on which I'm now standing is all that now marks the site of the first pit in Rhondda. It was in 1809 that Walter Coffin of Bridge End left the family tannery to prospect for coal here at the lower end of the valley. He started with levels driven into the mountainside, tapping the two upper seams of coal. Then, in 1812, he sank this pit. 40 yards down, his men struck the rich Bordringacht seam, the Rhondda number 3. It was this seam, nearly 3 feet thick, that became known throughout the country as Coffin's Coal. Early levels and the first pit made little difference as yet to the valley. It was still a rustic economy of sheep farming and forestry and domestic crops, and the crafts of smith and sawyer and miller that sufficed a self-reliant community. This was Coffin's second pit in Rhondda. It's walled up now and overgrown, but the shaft is still there, under the ferns and brambles, reaching down 80 yards to the tunnelled roads below. Under this ground, with naked lights and with only the most primitive ventilation, 300 men and over 100 boys hacked, sweated, cut the coal through the long hours of darkness. And along this narrow west bank of the river, between the two Dinas pits, in company cottage or lodging house, lived the first mining community of the Rhondda. It was the first smudge of dark mound and grey stone on the green pattern of the valley. There's not much left of this first industrial chapter in the story. Much of the old Dinas lies flattened under post-war factory sites. Many of the Dinas people have been rehoused elsewhere. What's left is practically deserted, awaiting the council shovel and bulldozer, the stone debris along the riverside that once housed a harsh and vibrant life of its own. In the derelict cottages and the gaunt tenements, the windows are empty sockets, blind eyes now above an empty lane, where once the coal trams groaned down the rough track to the canal and Cardiff. Once, every room here held a bed, and every bed a miner.
Llanganid, South Wales, 1909. 439. Hilton Colliery, Lancashire, 1910. 344. Whitehaven, Cumbria, 1910. 136. Cady, Maine, Yorkshire, 1912. 86. Riding Colliery, 1923. 40. Gresford Colliery, North Wales, 1932. More than 300. Cumbrian, Clydach, Lewis Murphy, and many, many more.
Have you seen the price of gold? It's much too high. Have you seen the price paid for coal? It'll make you cry when you realize from Saint-Denis. They all pay, the real price of gold. It was too high. God bless them, and God bless their souls. It'll make you cry when you realize the brothers, the lovers, the fathers and sons, they die for coal by the ton. Heroes, everyone. Heroes, everyone. And that's the real price, they paid for coal. It was too high that they should die. That's the price of
struggles become your sacred song. in the dark, dark light. I believe in you. I would thief for you. And I'll follow you faithfully, even when you lose your way. Crossing the line with you, tending the vine with you. Falling through time with you.
Sacrifice mine for you.